awake. I'm haunted by the law.
Sheriff, Wake's running. I'm giving chase.
Are you seriously telling me that Ryder just took out my deputies?
A thriller I supposedly wrote is coming true. The genre of the story seems to be shifting. It's turning into a horror story. I was told that Alice had been kidnapped, but that was a lie.
We don't have his wife. We don't know where she is.
Our purported kidnapper was eaten up by the dark presence before it attacked me.
Alan. Shh, baby. It was just a nightmare.
Alice.
There you go, Alan.
Hartman, I fell.
I had to give you a sedative. Don't fight it. You went through another rough period.
What?
Right now, it's very important that you stay calm. We don't want you to have another episode. You're a patient at my clinic. Have been for a while now. The shock of your wife's death triggered a mental illness.
No, you lie.
You're suffering from various symptoms of undifferentiated schizophrenia.
Bastard.
It's okay, Alan. Just let go.
Go, 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 go.
I felt groggy. Whatever Hartman had bumped in me was making me numb. I felt like this was happening to someone else. Someone I was watching on television. I couldn't think. Couldn't focus. The door was locked. I was a prisoner here.
Good evening, Alan. Are we feeling better now? Feeling calm?
Yeah. I see you brought your pet gorilla with you. So sure, I'm calm. I get the message, loud and clear.
Quite right. That's the spirit? You're being very brave, Alan. I understand you're confused. I would be more concerned if you weren't suspicious of me. I don't blame you for it.
Big of you.
Now, why don't you come with me? We'll reacquaint you with my clinic and go over everything you might have forgotten. Little walk and some fresh air? Yes, it will do you good. This corridor is for patients. Most of them aren't here right now. Jack took them out for a fishing trip. Except for the ones who are particularly vulnerable, of course. I encourage creativity as a part of the recovery process here at Cauldron Lake Lodge. I specialize in treating artists.
I bet you do.
Splendid, Alan. I honestly believe we can get this thing under control if we work together. This way, Alan. Now, Alan, from past experience with you, I know I need to get right into the heart of the matter as quickly as I can after an episode. So I'm just going to say this. Alice is dead.
No.
You're in a very vulnerable state until you understand and accept this. Alice drowned. And you couldn't face that. You're suffering from hallucinations, paranoid delusions, unusual thinking, an obsession about light and darkness, a feeling that everything revolves around you, your thoughts and dreams. Your mind has constructed an elaborate fantasy scenario in which your writings are affecting reality. She has been kidnapped and supernatural forces of darkness are trying to stop you. We go this way, Alan.
I wasn't ready for another shot, so I went along with it. He had to be lying. But under the influence of the drug he had given me, I had to fight not to believe his words.
It's all in your head. You've been making it up. Apart from the tragic accident with your wife, no one has been killed. Your delusions are just a manifestation of your subconscious mind trying to protect you from the too painful truth. Unless we fight the fantasy, it will return. I know the instinct is to resist me, but think about it. Doesn't this make far more sense than the insane supernatural conspiracy you have concocted in your mind? You're a skeptic by nature, Alan. We both know this. Everything can be explained logically. I'd never get tired of this view. Very inspiring, isn't it?
Cauldron Lake spread below us. I could see Mira Peak on the other side of the lake. I thought I could make out the spot where Diver's Isle had been when I arrived with Alice. Now there was nothing but waves.
It seems there's a storm coming. Funny, I don't recall there being a mention of that in the weather forecast. Well, no matter. This way. Follow me. Alan, what I'm telling you is good news. Right now, we're in control. Every time you have a relapse, it gets more and more difficult to resurface from the dark depths of your imagination. Not surprising, considering your profession. Imagination is what you work with. After all your nightmares, this should come as an immense relief to you. If it doesn't, why is that? Because I'm lying? Or because you don't want to admit that you're not well? It's very natural for you to think of me as your enemy. It's part of the illness.
I let him talk. Hartman obviously loved his own voice. His words echoed madly inside my head.
But I can't.
I dug my nails into the palms of my hands to stay focused.
You need to work with me. Once you accept that, we can begin the journey towards your recovery. Come along. Let's go inside. Here's the entrance to the office wing. That's for staff only.
Spooky. Come on. Scary.
Emerson.
I'm a real bad dream, mister. You should be afraid of me. Don't want to run into me in the night, that's for sure.
Please, Emerson. Mr. Wake is confused enough as it is.
Yeah, you'd like me to go away so you won't be scared. But you can't just decide what kind of dream you have or when you have it.
Emerson.
Okay. Sorry. Boo.
That's Emerson. We're actually making some progress with him, I'm happy to say. He works on video
elbow
games.
Strike.
Ooh, it's yeah. Trash, of course, but it does involve some small creative effort, which makes him receptive to my therapeutic methods.
No kidding.
Come, Alan, this way. Now, you might have noticed the typewriter in your room. You've been writing as a part of the therapy. As soon as you feel up to it, you should continue.
My rheumatism is killing me. There's a storm coming. Oh, what a storm.
I hope it wipes this place off the face of the earth.
And these two are the Anderson brothers, Odin and Tor. They had a heavy metal band in the 70s and 80s called Old Gods of Asgard. They even adopted new first names to complete the image of Viking gods. After the band broke up, they lived on a farm nearby. They are, well, in advanced stages of dementia. They're well cared for, TLC and all that. There's nothing more that can be done. I'm afraid that the rock and roll lifestyle has left its mark.
No, that won't do.
I'm so sorry to cut this short for now, Alan. The power has been acting up. I'd better go check on it. We'll continue this soon. Meanwhile, when you feel up to it, return to your room and try to write. It really is for the best. Don't you think?
I'd like to bash his head in with a hammer.
Oh, he'd love to fish out our secrets, but he has no clue. He's not crazy enough. Not crazy like us, Sonny. Being crazy's a requirement, Sonny. Who else could understand the world when it's like this? It takes crazy to know crazy.
That's the sanest thing I've heard in a while.
Sane! You're all right, Tom. Hey, we like him, don't we, bro? He's got to go to the farm.
The Anderson Farm. Valhalla!
We wrote it all down, lest we'd forget. A crash course. All you need to know to get your head right. You need to find the message.
Here, Sonny, here's something for you. Gave me a rash, but I kept it safe from these bastards.
My head was clearing up, or according to Hartman, I was sinking back into the fantasy. I was convinced he was lying to me about everything. Crazy or not, the Andersons made more sense.
Tom, you got any booze on you?
Yeah, no.
We have a stash of the special stuff at the farm. Our own formula, local ingredients, medicine, clears your head right up. Makes you remember like moonbeams on the brain.
Oh, I just noticed leather patches on the elbows. That's not very rock and roll.
Tom just lost is all. Baba Yaga got to him too, the damn witch.
She used us all, taken from all of us. Took my thunder, the witch.
And my ravens, what were they? Memory and thought, the hag.
She took something from you too, didn't she? That's what she does.
We're better off. This place, the lake, it gives you power. If you're a creator, an artist, a god.
Nightmare shifted in their sleep in the darkness of the lake.
Yeah, that's the one. She makes sure it comes out twisted and raw. Just ask the lamp lady. She knows what happened to that other rider.
She's been using you, boy. And you let her. You went and opened the door for her, didn't you?
Now, it was already open a crack. And whose fault is that? We're morally corrupt, disease-ridden, old and stupid.
Doesn't mean he had to open it all the way, goddammit.
You can't wake up. You can't hurt a nightmare because all dreams are only imagination. They're only in your head and they're not there when you wake up. So you can't wake up because I'm in charge now and I don't want to disappear. My nightmare is the publisher people who want to make a contribution so they can say they made a contribution. And then we end up with mullets in there because they think mullets are funny, but it wasn't supposed to be about mullets, and now it's about mullets. And when it's in slow motion, they call it mullet time because the numbers came back from marketing that mullet time is the hook we needed to go big in the target demographic. And they're not even kidding. They say it all like serial killers with straight faces and smiles. My nightmare is the writers who want to make everything from the characters to the toasters talk all the time and express their feelings so they won't shut up. And the writers won't shut up either because they have feelings too. And I have to listen to them because they're not scared of me. And everyone should just shut up. But I don't see nightmares anymore because I'm too scary for them. I take 2 pills every morning and 1 with every meal and 4 when I go to bed. And that makes me the scariest nightmare of all.
Oh, hello. I've painted you.
Okay.
I was just struck by inspiration a couple of days ago. Dr. Hartman wanted me to paint landscapes, and that's what I was doing. But now I've been doing these things, a lot of them. The images just keep coming. Dr. Hartman likes them. He has them in his office.
Yeah?
He's very proud of me. He says I'm getting much better. I think I'm getting better. Well, I guess I'd better start wrapping this up. The storm is almost here. I'd hate to be out there tonight.
Hey, Wake. Why don't you humor Dr. Hartman and give the writing a shot, huh? Typewriter's in your room. You can get to your room by those stairs, Wake.
Something's wrong. I'm not myself. It's hard to think. There's a shadow inside my head. I can only focus on writing. Everything else is a blur. I'm trapped in this cabin. Have been for days, but it's always dark outside. My editor is real. I saw her again. She's not human. It's not human. A dark presence is wearing the old woman's face. She was covered in clinging shadows. There's a hole in her chest where her heart should be. I think I've made a horrible mistake. I don't think I'm any closer to saving Alice. It's been lying to me, using me to get the story it wants, and the story will come true.
Hartman had mentioned that the power had been acting up. Maybe that was the reason for the generator and the work light on the balcony. The generator hadn't been activated, and there was no key. Hartman wanted me to write. I knew I couldn't, but I figured I should just play along for now. It was the only thing I could do with Nurse Birch watching me like a hawk. The white glare of the blank page in front of me hurt my eyes. My hands began to shake uncontrollably.
Everybody, calm down! Put that down! Burke, I need help!
Hey, Wake! You stay here. I'm gonna go see what's up. You just keep doing what you're doing. Be cool, okay?